The question number 17 is, does the force of gravitation exist between two astronauts in the space? Suppose there are two astronauts in the space, so does there exerts a force of gravitation, students? Yes, because in the space there is also a force of gravitation. Okay, the next question is, what is a force? Okay students, so what is a force? A push or pull of an object. This we have seen in the first slide of this session. That is, a push or pull on an object is called a force. Okay, now next. See student, this question is regarding the chapter number 11, that is pressure. So please ignore it. For this, I'm really sorry. Now the question number 20 is, at least how many objects are needed to apply a force? Okay student, here again I repeat this question. At least how many objects are needed to apply a force? How many objects are needed? Yes students, it is a logical question. At least two objects are needed to apply a force. Next question, question number 21. Give one example of gravitational force. So what is the example of gravitational force? An apple falling from tree to the ground. Okay, or any object which is falling from upward towards the ground, that is an example of gravitational force. Okay, next. Sorry student, this is also one question which is from the pressure. Please ignore it. See here, question number 23. What do you mean by a magnitude? Here we have already revised that the force has magnitude as well as direction. So what do you mean by the magnitude? Okay, so the answer for this question is, the strength of force is usually expressed by its magnitude. Okay, so what is a magnitude? The strength of force is usually expressed by its magnitude. Okay, what is magnitude? Here I again revise, the strength of force. Okay, how much force is applied over there, that amount is nothing but the magnitude. The next one is, what is muscular force? See students, what is a muscular force? The force resulting due to the action of muscles is known as muscular force. Again I repeat, what is muscular force? The force which is resulting due to the action of muscles. Here, whenever we apply any force on any object and we used over there muscles for acting the force at that time, we can say that the force applied over there is a muscular force. Okay, now next question. Question number 25. What is contact force? Yes students, what is contact force? This is we have also seen in the first slide of this session. The force that can be applied only when it is in contact with an object. Okay, whenever two objects are in contact with each other and the force applied over there, at that time that force is known as contact force. Okay, that force is known as contact force. What do you mean by the term atmosphere? The envelope of air around us is known as atmosphere. Next question. This question is logical question, or you have to think over here, application based question. So see student over here, two thermocol balls. Listen carefully and read carefully also. Two thermocol balls held close to each other. Two balls are there which are held close to each other. and they are move away from each other. First, we have two thermocoils which are closed with each other and they move away from each other. When they are released, the name the force which might be responsible for this phenomenon. Explain. Again, students, here I would like to again explain you this question. What is question? Think, students. Two thermocol balls are there which are held close to each other. Okay. First, we held these two balls, thermocol balls, close to with each other and then away from each other. So, what will happen when they are released? What kind of force is act over there and what is that phenomenon? What is the name of that phenomenon and explain. So, the answer for this question is, student, the electrostatic force is responsible for this phenomenon. Which kind of force apply over there? Electrostatic force. See, students, these two balls, that means these two thermocol balls have the similar charges. That's why they move away due to repulsion between them. These two thermocol balls are held in close with each other, but whenever we held that two balls with each other, they repel with each other, they move away from each other. So this force which is act over there is the electrostatic force which is responsible for this phenomenon. Okay, students. Now the next question. How does an applied force changes the speed of an object? How does an applied force changes the speed of an object? Suppose here we apply any kind of force and due to that force, the speed of object gets changed. Suppose here we apply the force of friction. Due to that, what will happen? In case of moving car, that speed of car gets slow due to the application of brake and at certain time it gets stopped. Okay, so here the question is, how does an applied force changes the speed of an object? We know that whenever we applied the force at that time, what will happen? The speed of an object gets changes. But how? How it is changes? So answer for this question is, see over here, if the applied force is in the direction of motion, suppose we apply over there force but in the direction of the motion, the speed of the object increases. Okay, suppose that ball is moved from place A to B and we apply the force to the ball towards the B direction from A. So again, the speed of that ball gate increases. But if the force is applied in the opposite direction of the motion, what will happen? The speed of that object will get decreases. Okay, students? The speed of that object will get decreases. Now the next. What is the similarity between electrostatic and magnetic forces? See, student, over here, what is the similarity between electrostatic and magnetic forces? See, the answer are, both are non-contact forces. Both are the examples or the type of non-contact forces. Because for the electrostatic force application, there is no requirement of two objects to be interact with each other. While in case of magnetic forces also, there is no requirement of two objects to be interact with each other. So the similarity between these two forces, that is electrostatic forces and the magnetic forces, are both are the non-contact forces. Also, one more similarity is there, students. What is this? Both are attractive as well as repulsive forces. Both are attractive as well as repulsive forces. Now, next question. What are the effects of force on an object? This question also we have seen in the second or third slide. What are the effects of the forces on an object whenever we apply on that object? Okay, so first answer should be force can change the state of motion of an object. Force can change the speed of moving object. Force can cause an object to turn or change the direction. Force can cause an object to turn or change the direction. Also, force can change the shape of an object. So these are the effects occur on any object after the application of force over there. So what are these? It can change the state of motion, speed of moving object, turn or change the direction, and the shape of object. These all are the effect of forces on an object. Okay. Next, see what is force and state the difference between contact force and non-contact force. Again, students, here I repeat, what is force? Force is nothing but a pull or push. Okay. So this is force, and what is the difference between them? See over here. Contact force and non-contact force. So students, if you think logically, what is the main difference between contact and non-contact forces? The name itself indicates that in case of contact forces, there is requirement of contact, while in case of non-contact forces, there is contact between two objects is not required. So see over here, students, the force that can be applied only when it is in contact, it is a contact force. Okay, force that can be applied when it is in contact with an object is called contact force. The example for the contact force are muscular force and a frictional force. While what is the difference between contact, non-contact? See, non-contact, the force which is exerted on an object without touching it is known as non-contact force. The example for this is gravitational force and magnetic force. Okay. Next one. This question is just like the long answer type question. See, students, over here, define different types of forces. There are different types of forces, and we have to define over here that forces. First, see over here answer, how to write the answer. Force can act on a body from a distance or being in contact with it. So depending on this, forces can be classified as contact and the non-contact forces. The first type of force is contact force. So what is contact force? When force is applied on an object by direct or indirect physical contact, the applied force is called contact forces. Okay, students, and what are the two examples of contact forces? Muscular and frictional force. Now we have to again define these two forces. What is muscular force? The force resulting due to the action of muscle is known as muscular force. While the frictional force, what is frictional force? The force resisting the relative motion of solid surface, fluid layers and material elements sliding against each other, it is nothing but the frictional force. So this is all about the definition regarding contact forces and the types of or the examples of these two contact forces. Now the next one is non-contact forces. What are these non-contact forces? When a force is applied to an object by another body that is not in direct contact with it, it's called non-contact force. That is, they are not in contact with each other. So what are the examples for the non-contact forces? Gravitational force, magnetic force and the electrostatic forces. These three are the example of non-contact forces. So First one is the definition of gravitational force. What is gravitational force? The attractive force of the earth which acts upon all the object is known as force of gravity or just gravity. What is gravitational force? The force of earth which acts upon all the object is known as force of gravity. The next one example of non-contact force is electrostatic force. So what is electrostatic force? The force which is exerted by a charged body on another charged or uncharged body is known as electrostatic force. Again I repeat, what is electrostatic force? The force exerted by a charged body on another charged or uncharged body is known as electrostatic force. And what is magnetic force? The force exerted between a magnet and other magnet or between the magnetic material is known as magnetic forces. Okay students, so this is all about the types of forces, okay, and their definitions. Next question. This question is logical thinking or the application based type questions. See over here. On Lokesh's birthday, Shreya was given charge to amuse children with some little tricks. Here again students, see over here. On Lokesh's birthday, Shreya was given charge to amuse children with some little tricks. Shreya stick balloons to the wall by just rubbing them in her clothes. Okay, what Shreya will do? Shreya stick the balloons to the wall by just rubbing them in her clothes. She bent the water stream from a tap without. She bent the water stream from tap without touching it. So she did so by bringing big balloon near to the flowing water. All children were very happy on seeing this little magic and everybody praised Shreya. What Shreya did over here? Shreya stick this balloon to the wall just by rubbing them in her clothes. He rubbed that balloons on her clothes and stick this balloon. Okay, now what she did, the tap water is there. She kept that balloon which is charged on rubbing on the cloth. So that charged balloon she kept near the flow of water from the tap. So tap water is there and she just kept that balloon towards that tap water. What will happen? That water will get nearer to the balloon. Okay, she did bringing big balloon nearer to the flowing water. Okay, so what is the question? How do balloons stick to walls? Okay, first question is, in that case, how these balloons are stuck to the walls? How Shreya bent the water stream by bringing a big balloon near it? Means that water stream get bent towards that balloon. So how does it happen without touching it? And what values of Shreya is shown over here? So students, this is the value based question or something application type question. So you have to just think over here, why these balloons or how do these balloons stick to the balls? See students, answer for this activity is, on rubbing the balloon with hair or clothes, it acquires the charges. Okay, something charges, that is negative charge, and whenever the negative charges are attracted to the positive charges on the wall, that balloon gets stick to the wall. That balloon get stick to the wall. Okay, so on rubbing balloon with the clothes or the hair, it acquires negative charges, and that negative charges are attracted to the positive charge of that wall. That's why that balloon stick to that wall. Next question is, how Shreya bent the water stream by bringing a big balloon near it and without touching it? So see student, the negative charge on the balloon, the negative charge on the balloon attracts the positive charge on water molecule, thus the bent the water molecules. That's why that water get bent towards this balloon. And what value of Shreya is shown over here? Shreya is dutiful, friendly, with this scientific aptitude. Okay students, so this is only the logical base or the application type questions. Here you have to think how we can apply the our knowledge regarding the force in this case. So students, thank you. If you have any query regarding this video or these question answers, so please feel free to ask me. You can send your queries to my mail ID. This is the mail ID. So you can send your queries here too. Now students, in this video, in today's session, this video contains certain questions which are regarding this pressure. So I'm sorry for that, because there are certain questions which are put over there by mistakenly. So please ignore that questions. But here I really covered all the chapter with the help of just revising this topic also, and also in the fashion, in the same fashion of question answers also. So students, please refer these question answers and think over that. What is force? What are the types of force? What are the effects of force? What is resultant force? Okay students, and what are the examples of that types of forces? Okay, and accordingly prepare yourself. I also take revision before the exams. Okay students, so you don't worry about your study, but you have to also learn each and every chapter so that you will get each and every video very easily. Okay students, thank you.